start by putting this in.
And as I'm painting it, you're going to be able to see it a little bit more. Hi, Stacy. Oh, yay, Crystal. I wanted to see these painted. Crystal, I think you're actually the one that had requested a splatter and chatter to be done live. So I think you're actually the one that gave me the idea to go ahead and show you one of these little splatter and chatters. I will probably have this available to buy tomorrow during the sale, or if somebody watching wants to purchase it, just get a hold of me. The last one I did sold before I even got done. So, but if you haven't tried this, you guys, it's kind of cool painting on the screen. I had never done that before. Now, I'm debating, and I'm thinking maybe all of you could help. I am using DIY paint. Yes, Patricia, I'm using DIY paint. This is an all-natural clay-based paint, and I do sell all of these products here in my studio. So I have a big shipment that should be hitting any time now, any day now. And so I will be getting a lot of these smaller sample sizes, but these samples are full 8 ounce, so they're perfect for artists. So, and I use it on all of my artwork. So, yeah, Heather bought my other one that I did, didn't you? You're right. Hello, Miss Lori, another local artist. Okay, so my question, I got sidetracked. Imagine that. Me get sidetracked? Nah, never. So, what do you want? Do you think I should just, I'm either going to paint the frame an accent color, which I think would be really pretty, or if you want, you could go ahead and extend the painting out onto your frame, just like you would a canvas, like a regular canvas. So you could extend your painting out over the wood as well. So, but I thought maybe I would give you guys the option of telling me what you would like better. Would you like a contrasting color? Or maybe we do both. I don't know. So I'm fairly new to painting on the screen. Hey girl, hey. Hello, Carrie. This screen, Jillian is asking, where did I get the screen? This screen just came from the Hoblobs, which initially I went to my restore because I would like to do this on, you know, I am girl upcycled, so I like to use things that are already out there and existing. But there wasn't any screens. There was nothing, you know, really that I could use. So when you do paint on a screen, you want to make sure it needs to be a thin screen. It can't be real wide. Maybe it could. I haven't tried it. So. But anyway, what do y'all think? Do you think I should do like a contrasting color? Now, if you are like Heather, Heather's the one that bought the last one that I did. She actually chose the frame, and what she wanted done was stain. So I stained the frame for her. So that's an option if you are the one that buys it. All right. So I'm just going to, so this part goes on pretty quick, guys. Right. And I'm going to do a little, I think they're called muffs. Maybe I'm wrong. Am I wrong? What's that called? That you put your hands in? Muffler? Somebody help me. Stacy, she recommends using a contrasting color. Yeah, I'm thinking maybe like a fun bright blue or a bright turquoise. Heather, she says, I think the stain you used on the floral was perfect. Good. She said it matches the other frames that she made. Oh, that's awesome. Patricia is voting for the frame to be painted in red. So, I'm a pest. Fox, what's that? What? Did I miss something? Did I miss anything? I don't know. Anyway, so when you notice I'm doing her little body here. So you want this to kind of look like her elbow. So you want to put a little angle right there. So it won't be perfectly round on that second one. You'll do a little bit of an angle. And then here's her little head. I'm going to put that on here. But this is something so easy, no matter, you know, how experienced you are. Everybody can do a snowman, right? Or a snow girl. So if you're doing this at home, what would you do your little snow girl like, or snowman? Okay, I'm going to try, I've got this color called Water Lily, and it's like a periwinkle. Gosh, it doesn't look periwinkle, does it? But that's what it is. I think I might add just a little teeny tiny smidgen. Let me see if I like it. That's the fun thing about painting, is you can kind of just try different things, and if you don't like it, you know, like I always say, we're not married to it, right? And I'm just going to just kind of crisscross a little bit of this in here. I don't know if you guys can see that. Are you able to see okay? I know it's a little difficult because it is a screen. It's not like the normal. A fox painting. I just did a fox painting. Are you asking me if I'm done with it? Guess what? I'm almost done. That seems to be my going thing. I'm almost done with it. I teach so much. I teach so many classes that sometimes it's hard for me to always get done. Anybody else? Just like any other project. So I'm just kind of putting little touches of the water lily in there. I think it looks pretty good. Yeah, Patricia says she likes it. It looks like shading. Thank you guys so much for sprinkling the love. This is what it's looking like. So the cool thing about painting on the screens is whatever you put behind it, like your wall, whatever color your wall is, that's kind of what your background is going to be. Kind of, it'll have that tone. So it's kind of cool. So it'll kind of match anybody's decor, right? Although I'm a firm believer that art does not have to match your couch or match your walls or all that, but right? All right. I'm going to rinse that off. Oh, you're interested in the fox painting. Oh my goodness. Okay. It's turning out so cute. I actually have that at home because my thought was, oh, when I get extra time at home, I will paint it. Well, then I have my paints here. So I'm like, I just need more paints. I need more paint supplies. That's what it is. Can we really have too many? Such a cool idea to paint on screen. I've never thought about that, says Carrie. Yep. Yeah. It's surprisingly, I liked it. I did not think that I would, but I did. All right. So I am going to add some more color to this. Now we're going to have a little fun, guys. This is where we're going to boho her up. She needs to have a little bohemian vibe to her, right? Let's see. I'm going to get this big brush. It might be a little bit too big, but we'll give it a try. I'm going to get... I'm going to put a little bit of Kissing Booth, which is kind of a fuchsia. Put a little bit of cowgirl coral which is, these are all DIY paints. And then I'm also going to maybe throw in some acrylics too at some point. Ooh. Hey, Shelly. How are you, my friend? Oh my goodness. What an honor. I hope you're doing well, girl. All right. Carrie is saying you're enticing me to paint on canvas or screen. Scary. Everybody's saying hello to Shelly. We love her, don't we? All right, so I'm going to, start with some of my pink kind of a shade here, and I'm going to just start tapping in, and it's kind of messy actually when you're kind of painting in flowers. That's what I'm doing. Flowers. And just kind of some in here. She almost looks like she has rollers, huh? That would be cute too. A snow girl with rollers. How cute would that be? There's the pink, the fuchsia kind of shade. And I'm just kind of doing this real, real loosely, kind of very loose. Okay, what other colors do I want? Well, I've got the coral here, so let's go with the cowgirl coral will be my next. Shelly, you're painting. Oh my goodness. So cool, girl. What are you painting? Who else is painting right now? Anybody? I'm just going to start tapping in some of this coral. Almost looks like hair, doesn't it? Carrie is saying scary. I was thinking of pushing myself to do an intuitive and give myself a couple of weeks. Wait a minute. Flinging paint and see what happens. That is never a bad idea. Intuitive paint is so... Well, first of all, it's very therapeutic. That is the first thing I think about that when you do the intuitive painting process. It's very, very therapeutic. And that can't be a bad thing right now because we can all use a little therapy right now, if you know what I mean. So, you know, and just start going for it. That's something that I do teach in my Creators Club, actually. But... You know, if you don't know where to start, I mean, just experimentation is going to be the best advice I can give you, is just to start throwing paint and not really, don't overthink it, okay? I'm using another color here. This is actually an acrylic. It is... Verity. I don't know if I said that right. I probably said that wrong. Hey, Brayden. How are you? I think, aren't you painting sometime? Don't you have a segment tonight? So if you all, Brayden that's on here, he is a local artist. And he has a segment sometime tonight as well. So if y'all want, make sure you follow the ArtCOZ page, you'll be able to see all these artists that we have. We have some really cool talent locally here. So I do like to show the talent off, the local artists that we have here. I'm pretty proud of all of them. So I'm just kind of, just crisscrossing just so that the paint lays in there a little bit. And you can come back over and add, you know, to it just to make it look thicker. So this is how it's looking so far. Again, this is screen that I'm painting on. It's just kind of fun. It's just something different, right? Something different. I think I'm going to go ahead and add maybe, I'm trying to look, I've got bit up here. Little flowers here. Just to make it all mesh. And this is whimsical. I know flowers aren't really that color, but I do love a blue flower. Even though they really don't exist too much. I do love it. That's the good thing about painting. You can make it exist. Okay. First segment. Yes, Brayden. First segment. What time is that? Ba-ba-boom. Yes, Judith. Snow girl. Yeah, thank you. Thanks, Shelley. Okay. I forgot. I want some cheese flowers like all down. We need to load her up with some flowers around here. Like she's, you know, she's a snow girl, but you know, maybe some of that snow has melted and it happens to be maybe it's springtime somewhere. I have to say, you guys, if you've ever been to Montana, oh my goodness, I actually could see snow and flowers at the same time. It was the most beautiful thing ever. I cried as soon as we turned the corner and you can see pictures of it and appreciate it, but oh my gosh, that was just, it was breathtaking. It really was. I don't know. If it wasn't for the winters that they have there in Montana, I would want to live there. Although it's probably a nice place to be during quarantine, I have to say. Hi, Christine. How are you? Hi, Susan. Good to see you. All my friends are showing up. All right, so there's that. Let's add some of the... Do you think it needs any other colors? You know, because a snowman, you know, you just got some whites and then what, right? This is a great way to add some color, some fun. Why not? So I'm thinking once I get done with this, then we can kind of decide exactly what the frame color should be. Is she on screen? Lolly, hello. My goodness, good to see you here. Yeah, she is on a screen. So this is what it's looking like. So painting on screen is fairly new to me. I'm gonna show you what it looks like on the back. And you guys, I don't know, am I crazy? Or, I mean, I think that's cool, because it looks abstract to me on the back. And I love that. So like abstract, whimsical. Pretty cool, I think. So I don't know, I'm enjoying this new found thing. need a smaller brush here. And, you know, those of you that know me, you know I gotta have a feather or two. She has to have a feather. So. Because it's my business. You guys, anybody hear that? What's that lady's name, that actress? She always says, it's my business. It's my business. I can't remember her name. Beautiful, beautiful black lady. I can't remember her name, but she's the prettiest. Like, you guys know who I'm talking about? She has the most prettiest skin I've ever seen. In my life. Because she always says, it's my business. Yeah. So we got a nice little feather there. You know, and we're going to do another one. Because it's my business. It's gonna be curly, maybe. And again, you guys, this the white color that I'm using, it's pretty thick, which works out good for the screen. It is clay-based paint. So it works out really nice for the screen painting. And it is White Swan, I believe, is what I'm using here. Oh, how fun, right? Oh, thanks. Carrie Fox, she says, I would put it with a holiday arrangement on my covered porch. Cute idea. Thanks, you guys. Let's see, I'm going to give you a close-up so you can see. Yeah, she needed feathers, you know, because more is more. Right? You have to love painting just fun little stuff like here, like this, because you don't have to overthink it, guys, right? You don't have to overthink everything. I do feel like there needs to be a little bit of some green. Get a little fancy farm girl on the situation here. I'm hoping. Oh, Shelly says she really likes the back too. I know, it's like abstract. See, I love abstract art. Love, love it. So, you know, you have the best of both worlds when you paint on a screen. You have an abstract on one side and whatever you regular painting on the front. All right, I'm going to use a little bit of fancy farm girl. This is just a nice vibrant green. And I'm going to switch back over to my bigger brush. I like big brushes and I cannot lie. Ditto, abstract, says Lolly. She's a wee transparent and that makes her interesting. Love the colors. Thank you. So I'm back over here to my brush. This is a Master's Touch brush. And I'm just gonna kind of scribble a little bit, for lack of a better term. I'm going to dip it into water and I'm going to get it a little more fluid. And I'm going to just do a little kind of scribble a little bit of that greenery in there. Just kind of give the illusion of, you know, leaves and whatnot. Here. And you don't have to be real, you don't have to be real defined with this, I guess, is the good thing. So, like the green kissing booth, the dark pinkish color. Yes, thank you, Stacy knew, she was on it. Okay, now let's put a little bit of, just a little smidgen of black on my plate here. It looks subdued. Yeah, mixed a little with the white. Yep, so right here, it looks a little lighter. Yeah, that's kind of the cool thing when you're painting pretty fast and it's kind of wet on wet, some of the colors kind of mix, and as long as you're careful about that, it works to your advantage. So like, whoo, goodness, almost dropped it. So like right here, it worked to my advantage that it mixed with the white a little bit, and it just made the petals look a little bit lighter, the flower looks a little bit lighter. So yeah, so as long as it's a something that mixes well, you're fine. So let's see, I don't know, let's see if we can put some decent eyes on her. Let's see, do a little cross, like one eye would be maybe about like here. Maybe, I probably could have made that a little bit bigger. So typically the space where the nose is about the same width as the eyeball would be, about that same width right in the middle. And this little eye, part of it's hidden because there's a flower right there. So that's okay too, right? I need some orange for her nose, right? Orange tone. When is your creative group open again, and cost? So I am keeping my cost the same. I just don't want to raise it, so especially not this year. And I am actually thinking about right after Christmas or in January opening it up, because I just feel like it, I feel like a lot of people are going to, I feel like the winter could be a little bit long this winter in particular. And normally I don't open it until spring, but I'm going to go ahead and open it up again. And it's a wonderful, wonderful place, you guys. We have some amazing ladies in there. It's just a great support. Okay. You learn a lot from each other, and We meet there every week and we talk a little bit throughout the week as well. So it's a really nice support. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and just kind of put a bit of a, I'm just going to start with a circle. A little circle for right now, and then I'm going to kind of create this little nose. Supposed to be a little parrot nose. But this class is in there. Is it looking like a carrot nose? Let's see. I like a little bumpy. There we go. I don't like a real perfect nose. Details are so fun. I think so too. Oh, thank you, Heather. I'm so honored to have you there. She said she loves the group. Now, if you want to, if I remember, I'll drop the link, or one of the ladies, Heather, or one of you, you could drop the link. You can get signed up for, so that you're on the email. So when I do open it up, you'll get notified. If you're interested, you can do that. Okay. Let's do a fun little... What? Carrie, you are talented. Carrie says, I'm cleaning my lower house gutters and watching you paint. That is some talent, my friend. Can I just say? Oh, goodness. A little heart-shaped mouth. That's pretty cute. I don't know if you can see. Let me see your little mouth. What else? I feel like I'm missing something. I feel like that needs to pop a little bit more. So I think I might add a little more of that paint. Did we decide what this was called? Is it called a muffler, you guys? Did we decide? I can't remember. It's some old school stuff here, a little vintage. She does. She looks pretty vintage, doesn't she? So if you all do not know already, every Wednesday at 11 a.m., that's Eastern time, I go live with Karen Crone, and we do fun, we just do all kinds of fun art, kind of artsy stuff. So you can catch us every Wednesday. Getting into some shenanigans. So if you're available, come hang out with us. Bring your coffee. Yeah, I think that makes it pop a little bit more, doesn't it? Okay. Thanks, Judith. Is it a muff? Okay, I thought it was, but then I was like, oh, wait, did I say something bad? I'm like, wait, maybe that's a bad word. I don't know. I shouldn't say that. All right. That tells you. Muffler. Muffler. I think the other is not a good word. Oh, shoot. Lolly says I caught the last one. Heather's laughing. You guys get my humor. I'm like a little bit ornery, like that much ornery. I don't mean to be, but sometimes. Yeah. Sometimes. Okay, I'm going to use a little bit of Queen Bee. Okay. I'm going to believe you, Julie. I'm just not going to say it just in case. Just in case it is a bad word. I don't know. All right. I'm going to take a little bit of this Queen Bee and just kind of add a little touch here. I don't know if it'll show up on to you guys or not. It's called a hand muff. I thought it was. See, I was all right. It's good. So really all I'm doing now is just any of the last little details, highlights or shadows or anything like that you want to add. I think I'm going to add a little more bright to the notes. And I'm just kind of putting some lines across it. Make it pop a little bit more. It's pretty close, I think. I think the next thing I'll do is maybe add a little bit of, let's try a little pop of red into the pink flowers. Just a little accent for that. And then we'll be pretty close to being done. Rosy cheeks. Oh, that's a great idea. Yes, I think she needs some rosy cheeks. All right. Jesus. Yeah, I highly recommend it though if you've not tried. Painting on screen, it's pretty fun. And I'm just kind of scumbling a little bit over some of the pink, just to kind of give it a little pop. And this is a really bright red. This is called Scarlet, is the name of this. Really loosely laying that in there. Hi, Jan. How are you? Can you guys see the red that I've just popped in there? Really makes it. Really brings it to life. in. We said we needed a little bit of rosy cheeks for her, and I agree. So I want this to be pretty subtle. So I think I'm going to use a really soft pink for this. Oh, I just got it on my jeans. It's a painter's life, guys. There's that paint on me. Okay. Just a little dab. Showing up too well. I don't know, guys, what else does she need? Anything? Does she need a necklace? This is what she's looking like. We should name her. So we can, if you look at the flowers, you can kind of see the red that I added made it pop out just a little bit. Actually, it makes it pop out quite a bit, doesn't it? So what do you think? So what should she be named? Sally the Snow Girl? I like that. Thank you, Christine. Any other ideas? Oh, I got a mean face. What happened? I see there's an angry face up there. Oh, shoot. So funny. I'm sure that was a mistake. All right. Anything else? So I need to know what you think I should name her, and what color do you think this should be? I'm almost thinking it would be cute. Like this turquoise color. Snowbell. That's cute. Feather Snow. You could call her Feather. So that's what I'm gonna leave it at that right now. This will be finished. Yeah, Christine, I'm thinking old 57 on the frame would be cute. It will bring this color out. So that's probably what I'll do. So if you do want this and you want to pick out the color of the frame, DM me. Other than that, I'm probably going to do it this turquoise color. This will be on the website for sale as soon as it dries and I get a picture up. So, or it'll be in the sale tomorrow. So those of you that missed it, tomorrow at 5:30, I'm doing a live flash sale right here in the studio, so you can shop right from your home. So if you have any gifts that you need to buy, we have a lot of things to choose from. I have brand new purses and bags in. You guys are going to love those. Don't miss it, because I did not get a high quantity of them. Okay. Jan says she needs a pink necklace on her. She does. I feel like she needs something, right? I feel like she might have a necklace or something put on her. What else? We have brand new ornaments. And you guys, my sister owns Earth and Summer's Kiln, and I have fresh ornaments in just out of the kiln. She had to do a 3-fire on these big ones that she made, and there's actual gold on it. So they are gorgeous. So those are going to be in the sale tomorrow. So please don't miss that. It'll be 5:30 tomorrow. All right, you guys, I am going to call it a night. Thank you so much for hanging out. Make sure you visit the ArtCOZ Facebook page, and you will be able to watch the artist all night long running different pieces of art. So I hope you go support them. Our town so appreciates you. So please go check them out. Give them some love and sprinkle the love out for all of them. All right. Bye, everybody. See you tomorrow at 5:30 for the sale. All right. Bye.